Welcome! In this video tutorial, I'm going to give you a walkthrough of how to use the much anticipated and very exciting new Luminar AI Sky Reflections tool. I'm Darlene with Digital Photo Mentor. I use my over 30 years of experience as a photographer to help beginner and intermediate photographers like you to improve their photos from capture right through to the end of the editing process. I use Luminar AI in my own workflow, and I'll show you how easy and fun it is to use, even for total beginners to photo editing. If you enjoy this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Stick around to the end, I'm going to have a bonus tip for you on adding your own custom skies as well. So let's hop over to the app and look at how to do Luminar AI sky replacement and reflections. I'm going to show you how to go from this to this. Are you ready? Let's do this. I'm going to demonstrate two different images. This first one, I've already applied some basic edits to brighten up the foliage and the grass and to just give it a little bit more contrast. So let's head over to the creative section in the tools panel. Just scroll down until you see Sky AI. If you've already tried the sky replacement feature in Luminar AI, you'll see that it looks a little bit different now. The first thing you'll notice is that the sky selection now comes with a set of thumbnails for the images. So you can actually see the skies, which is much easier to help you choose the one you want. I know that the one I'm looking for here is in the sunset cloud set, this one here with the nice red and orange clouds. So I'm going to choose this one. And you can see immediately right out of the gate, it's applied the sky and done a really nice job. Now let's just tweak it a little bit. The next thing you'll notice that's a little bit different is the sliders are now separated into five categories or different panels. So let's work through each of them separately. Starting with orientation, you have the choice of blending the horizon, which was the same as before. This is not a new slider. And vertical offset. This one used to be called horizon position. This one allows you to raise the sky or lower the sky based on the horizon line. So when it's set to zero, it's trying to match the horizon line in the image. If I raise it up, I'm just going to do that to show you what the blending slider does. You can see that there's a very well-defined line here between the old sky and the new sky. If you change this horizon blending slider to increase it, you'll see that it just softens that edge. So it's kind of like fading the new sky into the old sky. I'm just going to reset those by double clicking because the default settings did a pretty good job right off the bat. The next one is new. Horizontal offset allows you to move the sky left and right. And you can see that as I'm moving it, the reflection is going along with it to match side to side. I'm going to move this one a little bit to the left to get a little bit more of that sunset color over on the right in here behind the trees. The last one in this set here is rotation. So if you have an image where the horizon is actually at a slant, maybe you've taken the image crooked or you shot it at a diagonal intentionally, you can actually rotate the sky to match. That's not the case with this image, so I'm going to leave that at zero. But if you want to play with it, you can see what it does here just by pulling the slider left and right. Flip, of course, flips it inverse left to right. So I'm going to leave that one. So closing orientation and moving on to the next one. Now you have mask refinement. So these are all similar sliders to what we've seen before, but sky local is now gone and you see one called fixed details, which is slightly different. Okay, I'm going to zoom in here so you can see what these are doing. Now there's a little bit of a tricky blend here because there's lots of trees and the original, if I go back to see the before image, you can see there's a mountain line in the background here, right in this right area of the image, and there's some mountains behind the trees here. Okay, so how Luminar is going to blend those is based on these sliders here. Okay, sky global, if I take this to the right, it's going to blend the sky over top of things in the background. So for example, if there were clouds in the original image, it would then put the new sky over top of them and replace things in the old sky, the higher you take this global slider. Closed gaps is looking for things like gaps in between the trees, like that may have been missed between a branch or two, and trying to fill those in. The fixed detail slider works in a similar way. I found that sort of by playing around with the three of these, increasing and decreasing, make sure you're zoomed in to 100% when you're doing this, especially if you have a sky or an image that's tricky like this one to replace the sky. So make sure you get a nice blend using a combination of these three sliders. Moving on to scene relighting, I'm just going to zoom out. What the Relight Scene slider is designed to do is to match the lighting and the color tone of your image to the new sky. So if you put in a new sky that's really vibrant like this, but it's got a lot of blue and pink in it, the original image doesn't match so much. Also, you're going to be affecting the reflection with these sliders. So let's take Relight up to the top, and you can see that now, because the sky is fairly dark around the edges and moody, now the image is reflecting that as well. So I do like what that's doing. I'm just going to bring it down somewhere about in the middle. Relight Saturation, take a look at the center part of the water here and watch what happens when I drag up this one. You see a lot more color start to appear in the reflection. Okay, so keep in mind that the Relight Saturation is going to really affect that reflection. I like somewhere in the middle there as well. Generally, reflection is not going to be as strong of a color, so you want to make sure that it doesn't look overly manipulated. Relight Human is for when you have a person in the photo, and I'll demonstrate that on the next image. The next section is reflection. You only have one slider here to think about. It's just how much of the reflection do you want? So increasing it obviously gives you more of that reflection in here. Now, if we zoom in again, you can see that it does a really nice job in terms of determining where the reflection needs to go. Where there's ripples in the water here, you can see that there's ripples in the reflection. You can also see that where the water is reflecting the trees, it's not picking up the sky. So it's smart enough to know that. And also that there's this rock over here and it's not putting the reflection on the rock either. So it's done a really good job of interpreting that water and how to put the reflection in. I'm gonna dial that down a little bit as well, but keep it nice somewhere in the middle. It comes as a default as 50, and I find that usually a little bit more is where I end up. Lastly, sky adjustments. Defocus is going to come into play in the other image. I'll show you that in a moment. If your background in your image is out of focus or not crisp, you want to make sure that the sky matches because the sky is at infinity or further away than your background. In this case, the background's fairly sharp, so I'm going to leave this one at zero. Grain applies to if you're adding a sky image that has no grain to an image that has grain, they won't match. So this just allows you to add grain to the sky if that's a case of your image. These last ones are one that I use a fair bit. Atmospheric haze, let's take that all the way up to 100. Basically what that's doing is it's adding a little bit of a haze and softening the effect in the sky. And I usually bring this up midway or so, because when it's down low, you get a really punchy sky. And especially when you're dealing with something like this here, it wasn't super punchy. I want to give it a little bit of a muted feel. So I ended up around 60. You can see what that's doing. It's taking away sort of that really sharp contrast and bright colors at the top. Of course, you can always go up into some of the other basic tools like color and dial down the saturation as well. Finally, you can adjust the warmth and the brightness. So taking the warmth slider to the left makes it more blue. You can see the color shift happening there. Taking it to the right makes it warmer, so it's more yellow and orange. For this image, I kind of like the blue tone in the sky a little bit better and the pink, so I'm going to take it away from the orange. And you can decide if you want to brighten it and make it a little bit lighter and airier, or go with more moody. Now you'll notice that when I do that, the relight also applies to the rest of the image. So when the sky lightens, so does the rest of the image because I use that relight slider. Let's take a look at the before and after once again. Before, after. let's look at what happens if you want to change the sky image and just try a few others. This one's nice, but let's see what the other possibilities are. I'm going to go down to the custom collection. I have a set of my own Sky Pack images, which I sell on my website. I'll tell you about how you can add your own custom skies, and I will give you a special discount if you want to look at my Sky Pack at the end of the video. So make sure you stick around till the very end. So choosing custom, now I can scroll through, and I know that mine are at the bottom here. And let's just say I want to choose a different color and see how that looks. Okay, now you can see that once again, it's done a nice job of matching the clouds in the reflection, and I have all the same choices. I'm going to move this one over to the right so I get a little bit more of that sunset about there, so it's coming through the trees, and maybe move it down even a little bit, just so it's peeking over the hilltop there. Now that I've got the sky position where I want, and the sun is actually in the shot for this one, I might go ahead and add the sun rays onto this as well as a finishing touch. So how cool is this? If you think this is an amazing effect, give me a sky reflections rock in the comments below. I'd love to hear what you think. Let's move on to the second image. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it, and remember to subscribe to the channel as well. As promised, the second image has a person in it so we can try out that Relight human slider. Let's take a look at the before image of this one. I actually hadn't considered doing a sky replacement on this image, and I've processed it a few different ways previously, but I was playing around with templates and one of them had a sky replacement and I got this coming right out of the gate. And I was like, whoa, okay, that's kind of cool. So then I played around with a few different skies, added some sun rays and the birds, and came up with this finished image. Let me turn those off for now, and let's take a look at that Relight human slider that we talked about earlier. Turning off the sky AI, you can see what the sky replacement is doing and how it's done a nice job of relighting and filling in the color here and also the reflection. Notice how the sun appears on the horizon there, and you've got the sun reflecting in the water, which is very smart. So if I want to move my sky around, I can move the sun over a little bit more even if I want to play around with that, or I can raise it up a little bit as if the sun has come up a little and blend that bottom horizon a little bit more. So this was taken in Varanasi, India. And one of the things that I would like to mention here is that I used a lot of the atmospheric haze here because it's very smoggy and there's lots of sort of smoke in the air. And I wanted that to be represented in this image accurately. One thing I want you to make note of when you're doing your sky replacements is that the direction of light has to make sense with the original image. Here, I'm going to zoom in just so you can see. I used a flash on this one. So the sun was coming up behind him, but I used a flash in a large softbox coming from camera left. So if I had the sun coming from the other side, it wouldn't make a lot of sense. So make sure that the sun comes from the same side as your light source in your scene. Let's see what happens if I flip this one and the sun comes from his other side. It's really paying attention to these kinds of details that are going to take your image from good to great, because the sun coming from this side does not make sense when the light on him is coming from the other side. Let's take a look at those relight sliders that I mentioned earlier. Scene relighting. I've got the scene relight fairly high. You can see what it's doing if I turn it down. The boat is quite a bit brighter and almost has a pinkish blue tone to it. When I increase the relight, it now has more of a tint that's similar in color to the new sky. I'm going to leave that quite high, and I'm going to turn down the saturation a little bit in the relight. Now when I do relight human, let me dial that all the way down, you can see that the color on him is going to change. Watch as I dial it up to the right. Okay, so the more I go to the right, the more it's dialing in the similar tone from that sky. Okay, so it's now he's got a bit of that bluish tint reflecting onto him as well. Now, if I like that color, I can just go punch up the overall exposure a little bit because it's also darkened him. right? But I want to do another test here. Let's pick another image and see what happens when we pick one that is an entirely different color. Okay, let's go with this one with the pink streaks. I'm just going to reset this to flip it to the other side, so the light's still coming from the right, the left-hand side again, or camera left. And maybe move it over even a little bit more so we get a bit more of those pink streaks. Now you can see that the relight is still working, but you'll notice now everything in the foreground has turned more pink to match the new sky. So regardless of the sky that you choose, the relight is going to match the scene. The other thing I wanted to mention is that, remember I talked about defocusing? Now notice the background here is quite out of focus or unsharp because I had a shallow depth of field. So I've used the defocus to 3 here to make sure that the sky wasn't sharp against an unsharp background, which would not make any sense. If you change your sky, just realize that you might want to adjust some of the other things again. In this case, I might want to dial down the haze, and I might want to put back the warmth, maybe not quite so much, and put back the brightness. One other last tip is once you've applied your new sky, go back up to the top under the Essentials tools and go to Enhance AI, because that sky enhancer slider will now apply to your new sky. So it will darken and punch up the color of that new sky just as it would apply to the original sky. Now if I want to go back and turn on the augmented sky, that's where I added the birds. Let's see if they still work. There happened to be a lot of birds along the shore that day. They didn't appear in that particular image, but for me that makes sense and it does fit because those are a lot of fishing boats and the birds tend to hang around. So my final bit of advice is make sure that the sky is lit from the right direction, and make sure that when you apply it, the colors match, use the relight sliders, and any additional sky augmentations that you add, make sure that they match as well and everything fits to make it look like it's seamless. Remember earlier I mentioned the bonus tip? So if you want to be able to make your own sky replacement and reflection images, just go back to the Sky AI tool. So just click like you're going to choose a new sky. And then from the pull down menu, you'll see all of the different categories. At the bottom, the last one is custom. And then right below that, where it says show custom skies, click that. And a folder where they live will pop up. You'll notice here that I have my sky pack installed of 25 different skies. So that's how easily you can install the skies, is you literally just put them into this folder, and the next time you launch Luminar AI, they will appear under custom for you to choose. But what if you want to add custom skies and you don't have your own sky images all ready to go? I have a pack for you. 25 high resolution images for $29. But if you use the coupon YouTube Sky Pack, you will get 25% off. Just apply it as a discount code when you get to the checkout cart. You can see the kinds of images included in the Sky Pack, including a few night skies and even fireworks for something different. I'll provide a link to the Sky Pack for you below in the description, but you have to know this code to get the discount. To learn more about the Luminar AI Sky replacements, watch my comprehensive tutorial by clicking the video here now. And if you want to get 25% off my Sky Pack that I just demonstrated, click the link below me and enter the coupon code YouTube Sky Pack when you check out. Thanks for watching.